Hello, today I'm going to show you how to create these vector striped circles. Let's open a new document, set the fill to none and leave the stroke black. First we will create guides. Press the Ctrl and R buttons on your keyboard to show the ruler. Click in the corner, hold and drag. While you are dragging your mouse, press and hold down the Ctrl key as well. Now position the cursor over the center and release the mouse. Then release the Ctrl key. Next we'll create a line and rotate it around the circle several times. Press the letter P for the pen tool or select it from the toolbar panel. Then click on this intersection and draw a straight line. Hold down the Shift key to keep it straight. Switch to the selection tool and select the line. Then press the letter R for the rotate tool. While you are holding down the Alt key, click on this intersection to set the rotation point. Type 30 into the angle window and then click Copy. Now press the Ctrl and D keys on your keyboard 10 times to make more copies. Select everything, then go to View, Guides and choose Make Guides. Now we are ready to create our circles. Switch to the ellipse tool, click in the center and draw a big circle. Let's increase the stroke's weight to 12 points. Next, press the letter S for the scale tool or select it from the toolbar panel. Single click in the center to open the dialog box. Make sure the scale is set to uniform. Type 91. And then click Copy. Now press Ctrl D 4 times. Next, select the largest circle and then press the letter C for the scissors tool or select it from the toolbar panel. Click on this intersection and on this one to make two cuts. With this part still selected, press the Delete key a few times. Next, repeat the same steps with all the other circles, making a first cut at the next straight line. And again. Select everything, then go to Object and choose Expand. Click OK. With everything still selected, open the Gradient panel and choose White and Black Gradient. Change the type to Radial. Press the letter G to show the gradient annotator on the screen. Click in the center and drag your mouse out to apply the same gradient to all circles. Now adjust the slider. Let's set the location value to 60%. Select everything, group it together and press the letter S for the scale tool. While you are holding down the Alt key, click on this intersection to set the scale point. Highlight the number in the window and using the down or up arrow keys on your keyboard, adjust the size. Then click Copy. You can adjust the size by selecting the inner part and repeating the last few steps. With the inner part still selected, press the letter R for the Rotate tool. Click in the center, highlight the number in the angle window and using the arrow keys adjust the rotation. Finally, we will add a shadow. Switch to the ellipse tool and draw a small and narrow ellipse. Press the letter G to show the gradient annotator on the screen and adjust its position. Open the gradient window, reverse the gradient, and adjust it a little bit more. When you are done, press the Ctrl and semicolon keys to hide the guides. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.